Hi guys, Roy here, back in with another video, and it is, of course, Comic Book Wednesday. If you follow me on Twitter, at Robbie_Rebel, you would have seen I had received seven books for last week. Seven books for last week. Wow. So I had some reading to do. So let's just get down to business, shall we? Let's just, like, dive into it. We're getting, like, to the back end of Secret Wars now, thank God. I can't believe it's nearly over. Two more issues to go. Last issue is supposed to come out in December, which is next week. Yep, issue 7 just got released, so I have no idea what's going on there. Now, I did the stupid thing and I read Secret Wars issue 7 before I read Thor's 4, and that's the wrong way around. So, yeah, so we'll start with Thor's 4 Thirst. God's sake. I really thoroughly enjoyed this series as a whole. It was played out as a cop drama, which was really good. Everyone's got partners and everything. And it's Ultimate Thor, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, so the main villain in this is, we find out, is Ultimate Thor, who knows that Doom, that God Doom isn't true God. You know, he knows that he's just manipulator and everything, but he was sent out to destroy all the Donald Blakes and all the Jane Fosters, so these people will not tell people about the false prophecy. And Leaf God, Leaf Four Leaf, one of them. But no, was it Rune? Yeah, one of them. And 616 Thor, regular 616 Thor, not the female version, has clocked under this and is like, we will take you down. And so they do. And Ultimate Thor, I swear it's Ultimate Thor. I think, yeah. He gets defeated, but he's like, no, my hammer is mine. I will throw this hammer and this hammer will not stop moving until I die. And the funny thing with that is that the hammer actually lands on Asgard post-Secret Wars. So when all Secret Wars is over, the hammer will actually land on Asgard, which is a weird thing. But also, the other part of this story is that 616 Lady Thor is at the Grand Hall, and she's trying to tell all the guys, look, God Doom is bad, God Doom is evil. Come with me, brothers. For the power of mighty Thor, we will defeat God Doom. And half of them are like, yay, and half of them are like, no. And then, like, they all start fighting. And then, like, at the end, they all just go, like, yeah, we'll go kill God Thor. Yeah, whatever. But in all, I'm going to give this book itself a 4. 4? I'll give it a 4. I was very... This is good. And overall, a story is overall, because now this is the finale of this issue. I'm going to give this series a 5, because I thoroughly enjoyed Thor's all the way through from issue 1 to 4. So the series as a whole, 5, because it was thoroughly enjoyable. This issue, a 4. So, boom. The cover art's bland as anything, isn't it, to be honest. The next we have Infinity Gauntlet 5. Again, this is the last issue of Infinity Gauntlet for Secret Wars. So now this has ended. What we see is that Thanos has 5 of the 6 Infinity Stones, and he is just literally just going on a rampage. But he needs the last stone, which is held by this girl, the Reality Stone. So, you know, Thanos is like, look, give me the stone and I'll let your mother live. They're like, no, you cannot have this stone. But in the end, she actually tricks Thanos and gives him a stone that she created with the Reality Stone called the Death Stone. It's like, oh, there you go, here's a stone. And so Thanos puts a Death Stone into the Infinity Gauntlet and dies, just like that. And then everyone lived happily ever after. I think this story could have done a lot better. There were a lot of, like, you know, mark out moments in this story. This issue, I'm going to give a 3. It was good, just not great in my opinion. The story is overall, again, I'm going to give a 3. So, yeah. And next, we're going to go to Secret Wars itself, issue 7 of 8. Again, I'm so confused now. I've been confused since issue 5 about what's going on in the main title. It just seems like if you don't read literally every single tie-in, you're going to get lost. So now literally every domain in Battleworld is now converged onto Doomguard and is attacking Castle Doom. Now, whether that's because they are attacking Castle Doom to kill God Doom, or just other domains are attacking other domains because they just want to rule Battleworld. This is all just like, everyone's fighting everyone, basically. You've got the Maestro coming in with his helicarrier made of skulls. You've got the Thors coming through. You've got, like, Captain Marvel with the Sinister Squadron coming in with, like, Sinister's clone army. You've got Reed Richards and Ultimate Reed just, like, trying to, like, control everything. Like, oh, do this and do that. And then it's just a bit of everywhere, really. Like I said, I'm happy this is actually coming to an end with two last issues. The main part about this story, which was really intriguing, was the end part. With Black Panther has gone to the wall and blown it up. And obviously, everyone knows that the wall keeps off the Marvel Zombies domain. And like, so he's blown up the wall, the Marvel Zombies are coming through, they're like, ah, brains, ah, we're going to kill you, blah, blah, blah. And like, Black Panther's like, stop! You all want to know, you want to be honourable, you do not want to eat us. You will follow me into glory, and we will get rid of God Doom, and you will be free of your existence. They're like, what? Zombies. Power and glory, power, and then all the zombies are like, power and glory! And they're like, if you follow me through this portal to Doomguard, we will destroy Dormgood. I keep on saying Dormgood. God Doom, we will free you of your existence. Like, we power of glory. And so now, Black Panther is the king of the undead. Who would have thought that? So there is a lot of action scenes in this. And it is quite like, you can just tell it's like coming up to like the penultimate end now. Thank God. We have two issues still to go. I'm hoping the next two issues should come out quite quickly, since December is the end. They can't delay it anymore. They really can't. Like, Secret Wars was supposed to end last month, for heaven's sake. Last month. So I'm going to give this book a 4. And obviously this isn't the last issue yet, so I can't give it an overall story arc finish. So this book is a 4. I do like the artwork, though. Okay, next book is We Are Robin. I have not read this. I haven't read the past 3 We Are Robins because I'm dropping this series. It's not because I'm not enjoying it that much. I just feel like that I have to read the other Batman books to understand what's going on. And also, I'm doing it for budgetary reasons. I'm cutting this out. This is my last DC book. I have 0 DC now in my pools every month. So I'm just dropping We Are Robin. Sorry, guys. Sorry. I'll hear what happens with you from Mark. It's cool. So, yeah, I'm just like not applicable for a score on that one. Next is Back to the Future issue 2. Okay, this has two mini stories in this. The first one is that Doc Brown is approached by the US government to build a time machine. And he's like, okay, I build a time machine in the future, but I don't know how I go about it. Am I helped by the government? Am I not helped by the government? Do I do it on my own? So he's like, so he gets approached by the government. Look, we want you to build a time machine. And so he's like, okay, I'll do it. And at that moment, he says yes. The government go away, and Marty comes back from the future in the DeLorean, and he's speaking Russian, and takes him into the present. And in that timeline, war is everywhere. Everyone's speaking like different languages, and what Doc finds out is that because he built a time machine, the Russians then go and build a time machine, and instead of Star Wars, race to space, it was a race to time, and everyone made time machines instead of going into space. And with that, Doc Brown decides, right, no, I'm not going to build a time machine for the government. Screw that. In the second story... I need to remind myself. Bear with me. It'll just all come flooding back to me in a sec. When was the second story? Oh, okay. Yeah, I remember that. Right, so in the second story, Marty's like going through Doc Brown's things, like say, oh, look, I was supposed to do a science experiment. I ain't done it. Give me something sciencey. So, and while Marty's going through all the sciencey things, Doc Brown's trying to figure out what do I make the time machine out of? Like, literally, like, how do I do this? So Marty discovers magnetism. And it's like, oh, right, I'll go do this. And at the end of the story, you find a newspaper clipping about a DeLorean being sold. And that's how the DeLorean is, you know, being sold. Quite frankly. Yeah. The first story, very good. Second story, not so good. This issue overall, I will give a 3. I'm really loving this Back to the Future series so far. It's all just mini stories. And I can't wait for issue 3 that comes out next month. You know, the comics aren't mind-blowing because obviously they're not like part of the main canon, the main stories of Back to the Future movies, but it's like little side stories, but it's cool, you know? So yeah, I'm going to give that a 3. I do love the cover art. Next we have All New Wolverine. Obviously this is X-23 taking up the mantle of Wolverine, because obviously, you know, Wolverine's dead. And what we find out is that she's on the mission to stop some terrorists in France, believe it or not. Wow, I just realised that. That's weird. And she's trying to like defeat them and stuff, and she's like having a bit of a meltdown because obviously this is like the first what she's doing. She's like, she's become the Wolverine, you know, she's like, it's a big, you know, honor and a big responsibility to do. And she has a bit of a breakdown, and she has there's this dream sequence where she's having with Wolverine, and Wolverine's like telling her like, you're me, you can do this, like he believes in her and all that crap, which is a really nice scene. And she does defeat them, and Angel's there, you know, Angel's there to save the day, helps her out. And I really, really enjoyed this book. I have high hopes this series going forward, because the Marvel Universe needs a Wolverine. Like, you know, maybe not Logan himself. Obviously, 6 months since Logan, he ain't coming back for a while because they're doing too much now. Marvel doing, with the reboot and everything, Marvel doing too much to have Logan not be involved. No, they're doing too much for Logan to be involved. Yeah. So they're going forward, obviously, with this Wolverine, and then they're going to go forward with Old Man Logan in January when that starts. And I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that because I love Old Man Logan. I'm really happy it's getting ongoing. And I'm really happy that, you know, we've got a Wolverine book. And I'm really, really looking forward to where this goes. So I'm going to give this actually a 4. If you're wondering what this poster is, this is how I like file my comics in the comic books. I put like a little post-it. Oh, look, only Wolverine, blah. Yeah. Okay, next we get into the heavy stuff. We got All New, All Different Avengers 1. Okay, so this was a really, really interesting book. Okay, just blah. This is a really interesting book because at the moment, this again was split into two parts. The first part is you got Sam Wilson just on a bridge, and this bridge is being attacked by something. And Sam Wilson's there. He's like, you know, defeating the bad guy. I don't know who the bad guy is. I forgot. He's like, saves the day, and he's being crowded by the public. He's like, oh, Captain America, can we take a photo? Can we do this? Can we do that? Like, yeah, cool, come on. And then he sees Tony Stark in the crowd as well. He's like, hey, who wants a picture of Iron Man? And which is quite funny. And then like Tony Stark's like he gets involved. And Tony gives Sam a ride, and they're talking about how Tony is like poor now. I don't understand why. So Tony's poor now, and he had to sell Avengers Tower, Avengers Tower is no more. And they're talking about how they haven't come up with a new Avengers team yet. Like, the Avengers don't exist yet in this book. So what we're getting here is literally the start of the new All Different Avengers. Which is amazing. Like, Tony's like, alright, cool, we'll start a new Avengers team. But obviously I don't know how. And that is like, that's that story basically. It's like, you know, Captain America and Iron Man, like, yeah, we're gonna start a new Avengers team. Okay, cool. And the second part of the story is about Nova and Miss Marvel. So there's this like bad dude in like Miss Marvel's territory. And she goes to fight it. And Nova's already there fighting it. And like they don't know each other. They don't know how to trust each other. They don't know, like, you know, whether to trust each other. They don't know whether to like each other. They don't know. So, like, they got talking. And, like, then they start trying to impress each other. And at the end of this, Nova takes his helmet off and reveals himself. And then that freaked Miss Marvel out. And she's like, oh. And Sam's like, okay, it's your turn. Tell me who you are. And like, she's like, no. No. And runs away. So it's like, so you got like the two main guys in the Avengers. Obviously, you got Iron Man, Tony Stark. They're like, getting, oh, let's make a new Avengers team. And then you got like the kids of the group, which are going to be obviously Kamala and Sam. And they don't like each other. or Sam wants to know Kamala. Kamala's like, no, go away. So, like, you got some, like, you know, some different personalities going on there. So, like, oh, this is just going to go great, you know? So, again, I'm going to give this a 3, because I don't know, obviously, where this is going. But it's laid some good foundation, so I say. So, yeah. And the last book is Uncanny Avengers Part 2. I picked up the Uncanny Avengers as well as All New, All Different Avengers because of the team lineup. The team lineup is very, very intriguing. You got Deadpool, you got Rogue, you got the Human Torch, you got Old Man Rogers. You know, it's really, really intriguing. And I understand what the point of this book is. The point of this book is to try and get all different kinds of people to work together. You know, you got like the Inhumans in this, you got X-Men, you got mutants in this, you got your regular Avenger, and then you got Deadpool. Deadpool is his own entity. No one likes Deadpool. Everybody in this group hates Deadpool, except Steve Rogers. Steve Rogers is willing to give Deadpool a chance, but no one else likes Deadpool at all. And like, Rogue can't get on with, who can't Rogue get on with? Rogue, what's her name? Synapse? Is it Synapse? Rogue can't get on with Synapse, and Johnny can't get on with Rogue because, you know, he's now inhuman, apparently. So yeah, the story concentrates on the villain, who is the Something Man? What's his name? I don't even know who his name is. Bear with me, children, bear with me. Come on. Is it the Scrapper Man or the Shredder Man or something like that? Oh, it's really annoying me now. The Shredded Man. There we go. The Shredded Man. Yeah, the Shredded Man. And obviously, they all need to defeat him. And they can't do it because they are not able to work as a team. You got Dr. Voodoo. Fucking, when the last time Dr. Voodoo was relevant? Such a weird team. It's literally the most thrown together team in existence. It's weird. You know, because tensions have risen, because no one can get on, and everyone keeps on disappearing the scene. And they're like, okay, we'll do this and we'll do that. And like, Johnny's trying to adapt without being around the Fantastic Four. And Rogue's trying to adapt to work with an Inhuman and not be around the X-Men. Steve Rogers is trying to really, I think he's just trying to outdo Sam with an Avengers team. And Deadpool's just Deadpool. Deadpool's like just letting the fame of being the Avenger go to his head more than anything. And they just can't work together. And they're trying to get them to work together. And that's the point, I think, of this team of Avengers. Because Steve Rogers likes to call them the Unity Squad. But I'm really looking forward to where this is going forward. This book, I'm going to give a 3 again. Because all the Avengers books, I don't think is going to be great at the start. However, I am looking forward. My TV just turned off. And now I have a blue screen. Blue screen of death. Turn off. Turn off. There. Yeah. So that's that, really. So I hope you enjoyed my video this week. I know it's a long one. I do apologise. Keep recognising those pages. And we already have an Avengers thing going on in, was it January it starts? The next Marvel event. Thanks for keeping that, you know, short and sweet, Marvel. Like, we ain't got enough to pay out for with Secret Wars. So I'll catch you guys later. Keep an eye on those pages. Rebelize, Super Size, with that shebang. And yeah. Skadoosh.